Marcolino. Don't be so serious, Matthew. Listen, Matthew, back off, mate. This is not a Hinch interview, okay? You can't intimidate a camera. Cameraman, either. In all seriousness, Matthew, this is the day of your farewell. I mean, it's not your farewell, is it? You'll be staying on.
Yep.
But in fact, it's sort of four years that you're going to...
Yeah, there's might no... as well leave, Matt.
I mean, what's the point of you staying on, Matt? Honestly.
Okay, well, listen, Matthew, I've got a couple of questions to ask. The first is an in-depth question. Any good memories of Barrow High?
I've got one.
One, yes.
Just one big one.
One, is it? Go ahead.
Yeah, she's left. No. I was only back a few weeks when there was a few girls just sitting down there on a hot, hot summer day.
Right.
And me, there was a bit of a water fight going on with the lunch boxes and stuff.
Yeah.
And we decided we'd fire up. So we filled up a garbage bin. And me and Ben and sort of snuck up behind them and
right.
We drenched three girls to like
right.
To there, you know. Just soaked. That's just the big one for me.
Yeah.
Me and Ben.
Righto. Now listen, I want you to take me on a bit of a tour here.
You've, bit of a tour.
You've got a space over here that you call Year 10. Just talk me through this.
Year 10.
Yeah, well, Year 10 area. What do you do?
This way?
Yeah, down this way.
This is where it all started. The rocks, the garden. That used to be a garden.
It used to be a garden, yeah.
But since we arrived, it's sort of...
You've changed.
We've changed the
format of it.
Right, yeah.
Right.
Started from here and then... Oh, we're getting sick of having nowhere to sit except for these rocks.
Right, who are these guys in front of us? Just mention a few.
J.D. Tolman, Jerry Piper, right. Rachel Perry, Jane Armstrong,
right.
Julie Farron walking down.
Right, right.
Yeah, we used to sit on the rocks in the garden, but then right. We saw everyone else with these seats and we thought, hey, they're young enough, they've got seats, we haven't got seats. So we went and beat up a few kids.
Right.
Now, we come up here, past the bar.
And yeah, now you've got this beautiful garden setting with garden furniture. Oh, beautiful.
Playing fields to the left.
Right, so you've got something to observe while you sit.
Seats to the right, canteen, just
canteen in
a mazy out of the
stone's throw away. Well, who are these students? Introduce us to a few of the U10.
This is my great friend and long time foe,
right.
Leif McKay. Meredith Pate. I'm sure you know Nathan Pankhurst. That calls us Jonathan.
Yeah.
Jonathan.
Yeah. Yeah. I enjoyed that, Jonathan. Okay. Listen, fellas, as you look at tonight, what anticipations do you have for tonight still?
Oh, well.
It's set to go to 11, but I don't think it'll last that long.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Is that
finishing 11?
Yeah,
okay.
Everyone's just
I'm looking forward to hearing
you other places.
So there are parties after the party?
Yeah.
Or before.
Before the party.
I'm gonna go crazy.
Camp this was, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's hear it. Well, come on, Steve.
All right. Steve's going to start. All right. He was on the end of my bed, just wearing his underpass. Like, this is in the middle of the night when everyone's supposed to be asleep.
This is fairly typical for John.
Yeah. and right. The teacher walked in and he got in trouble.
Right.
And he had to sleep in the mess hall. He had to sleep in the mess hall in his underpants all night.
Dead set.
The teacher said he wasn't allowed to get any pants.
He wasn't allowed to get any pants on. He had to sleep in his underpants in the mess hall.
Tell him why he came into your bed.
Why? Was he sitting on the end of your bed?
He was, he wanted a bit of...
His normal carry-on,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Why did the chick cross the road? I don't know, Matt, why did the chick cross the road? Oh, don't you know?
What's the story, is that, guys?
Why did the orange cross the road? I don't know, mate. Why did the orange cross the road?
I thought you knew.
I thought, what are you going on about, man?
And Brad? Ben, you've got something to tell us about Brad?
What? You want to know why he's...
Yeah, why is it that you call him Mushroom Head?
Why do you think? Because his head looks like a mushroom, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right here.
And this is part of our Shame Erskine file. This person wants to remain anonymous. She's going to now tell us a story that Mr. Erskine is most interested to hear. Okay, Madam X?
Okay, we used to be in this writing workshop class, right? We had to do this end of year assignment. Yep. Writing workshop, we had to write a novel on the computer.
Right.
And we were around in Mr. Erskine's office.
Right.
And we found this letter opener with a rat on the end of it.
Yes.
So we decided to write this really egotistical story about Mr. Erskine, how he was really up himself.
Right.
And he thought he was unreal because, he just thought he was really good.
Good.
And so we printed it out on the computer and left it on his table, signed the rat.
The rat. And to this day, he doesn't know who's done it.
He still doesn't know who did it.
Right.
Thanks, James.
There you go.
Okay. Why did the baby cross the road?
Nice and layout.
Why did the baby cross the road? I don't know why.
Because it was stable to the chicken.
Stable to the chicken! These, some of them are real hussies now in Year 10. And they've got something to tell you, Mr. Dixon. What is that?
Thank you.
Yeah. Making it possible for all our Year 10s.
Hey, treasured as a keepsake memory. And now that they're leaving, they're going to tell us one of the worst memories they've got. Barrel High.
The best memory.
Best memory, is it?
We've got a Barrel High.
Yes.
When we come to school pits.
Did you?
It was good.
It was good? And it was the only way that you could handle what?
What's
the
teachers.
Teachers. Who in particular did you find hardest to take?
Mr. McCrae. He was a pushover to get out. We didn't even get in trouble. Miss Ash
was nice.
Yeah.
He pushed him over.
Because we got away with everything.
Got away with everything there.
We didn't even get suspended.
Yeah.
We got one discipline slip. Right. And I thought it was pretty good.
Hey, right. Thanks for the memory.
I was cheered, yeah?
Thanks for the memory, guys.
Are
you guys? Are you guys serious?
Yeah.
Is that all you can produce? Are on every police file in the state of New South Wales. But tonight they want to come clean. Tonight they want to rub the record pure and holy. Righto?
Mr. Perot, we're not drug dealers.
These guys are not drug dealers. They look honest. They look clean to me.
He's the drug dealer.
He's the drug dealer. Revelations.
And Sergeant, whatever his name was.
Yeah, you guys are clean.
There's only train driver.
Right. Thanks, fellas, for clearing that up. What's just happened here? Someone's chucking peas. Did I hear that right? Did I get it right? Who was it?
I did.
Oh! Now it's a real hit.
I did throwing peas at Matt. It's really gross.
So Heidi.
Dirty
pea chucker.
Mr. Crick is a psycho commerce teacher and a psychopathic maniac.
Yeah, wasn't it?
You feel he is? What makes you think that?
Well, we're in class and Linda Edwards and a few others got it, don't get wrong, and put his hand through the overhead projector.
Dead set.
Class flew everywhere and the class was dead quiet.
Yeah.
Next day we came and gave him more crap, didn't matter.
Didn't matter. Okay, so where do you think he should be? Not in a classroom?
Can you tell? Mental institute. Yeah.
Right.
Definitely.
Yeah. Okay.
This college should be there too. Yeah, take Mr. Cullen.
Thank you, Jack. In the shame pile. What confession do you have, mate?
Well, I was chucking tennis balls at Mr. Wright before.
Really?
Yeah, I was.
You can confess
that
now?
I confess.
Okay. Did you hit him?
Yeah, we'll try and aim for his ball patch.
Dead set. What prompted you to do that, Andrew?
Pardon?
What prompted you? What made
you? Oh, you're the only teacher in the quad.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. And you're part of what? The, what do they call them? Meathead gang?
Nah.
The
dudes.
The dudes.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations, mate. Thanks for being part of the show. Gus, what have we got?
I've got my L's after 16 goes.
16 goes?
Yeah.
That's pretty impressive.
You're not wrong.
You're very honest, too.
Yeah, that'll do.
Yeah, thank you. Have you got a story to tell us, Tarina? I think you have.
Yes, about Madam X.
About Madam X? We can't... All right, now we can't see it. Tarina, what's the story?
Well, she was looking at someone without realising.
Yes.
She was looking at something very private.
Indeed. Thank you, Tarina.
Madam X, you got a show up.
Madam X, you're not Madam X, are you?
That one.
No.
Over here. No? Mr. Again.
I'm not Madam X.
Yes. Okay.
Don't be silly.
Before we can start some music and dancing. Still waiting. Wonderful. That's good. Well, I've got two or three people who'd like to say some words. Rachel Parry would like to say a few words on behalf of the people who are staying at school. And Cameron Brown. She's going to say a few words on behalf of the leavers. A popular choice, Bruiser. We have one or two other messages after that, and I'll just say a few words, and then we'll finish off. But Rachel, come on down. Well said, Cameron. Thank you for those words. Catherine Orman has a little announcement or a message. It's only a short amount because Catherine's so wonderful.
We invited Mr. Dixon to this function, but he couldn't make it, so he wrote us a little letter. It says, "Dear students of Year 10, thank you for inviting me to the Bower High School Year 10 Fit Semi Formal. I'd very much like to attend this function, but due to the distance involved, I am unable to do so. I trust that you have an enjoyable evening. Best wishes to all, whether you are leaving school or returning to your event. Yours sincerely, Mr. Dixon." Thank you.
The next award. The next decadent award 1990. Falls under the category the Winfield Bumper Award Contribution to School Environment. It's got something to do with non-smoking, I think. Maybe not. First nomination. Damien. I've cut that out to 5 packs a day. Travis, what do you mean smoking stunts, Jero? The third nomination is Kerry. Oh, I can't wait until recess, Timmy. Ronald Chimney Stack Galvin. An old friend, Melissa, who believes the ads about health risks anyway, but Melissa, do you, what would be different from everybody else in this? And of course,
oi.
Joshua, what about some heavy stuff? Who would? Awards and the famous Emmys. But has anybody ever heard of the Barrel Barbies? The Barrel Barbies are awards for decadence above and beyond the Call of Duty, leaving those aforementioned people way behind. This coveted trophy will take pride and place on many a mantelpiece throughout the Southern Highlands. The first Barrel Barbie Award. First Barrel Barbie Award ever. In the category, the Ashford Impeccable Uniform Award. A lot of contenders for this one. Russell Mittagong rules Guernsey down. Ben Cons, I've got a sponsorship deal for Long Life Shoes Olsen. Michael Tracksuit Fixation and Bill Nutton Lookalike. Travis Quicksilver and Corduroy Shorts and Newman. Andrew, Just Jean sponsored attire and fluoro shoes, can Natalie? Damien, I really do have pee every day, Sir Elton. And of course, Cameron, Lambo Oakley t-shirt, walking billboard, brown. This is an exciting one. Who have we got, Catherine? And Cameron Brown. The next Barrel Barbie Award, in association with the Decorative Awards 1990, is the Teacher's Pet Award. There weren't many contenders for this one at all. However, we're open to find a few. The first nomination, Tim. Ask me, I know. If not, I'll ask Mr. McRae his best up. And you, Smoothie. Ben. I like English teachers. Oh, what a feeling. Language. Jane, I love her. Universal bootlicker at assessment time call. Belinda, the all-round admirer of all her teachers, Britain. Wonderful student. Surprise contender, Catriona. May I speak to you after the lesson, please, sir? Well, the one over there with the red face. And Damien, why are you giving an award to your best student, Elton? The Teacher's Pet Award for 1990 goes to, oh surprise, Belinda Britton. Cricket for couples. Felicity and Danny Wright.
Yeah!
For their portrayal of a possessive couple in Hot Moves, which made 9.5 weeks.
I agree!
For the writer, Catholic Manual for Celibacy.
I agree!
And of course...
Shut up!
And of course, Damien and Alison and Damien and Sharon and Damien and Jeff.
Thank you.
just a couple of very quick ones. A little bit of trivia for you. On the year 8th camp, there was 115 kilograms of lollies consumed. That's a kilogram per head. And here's one. Does anybody know who came second in the girls' beach sprint in the 1987 Year 7 picnic day?
Jackie Axis.
No. Jody Tolman, come on down, there's your certificates. Other certificate winners from the 1987 Year 7 picnic day, Mr. Dixon would be pleased and proud of me. Brendan Castles, Belinda Britton and Carolyn Morrow. And collect your certificates, clogging up my drawer.
Excuse me.
the fortunate people who stayed behind to clean up the rotten mess that these 100 and what was it?
1123 on a Friday night.
Right. The 23rd of November. And here's the mug.
We are the idiots that stayed behind.
All right.
The sole remainders.
Okay.
The final remainders.
I want you. Stupid people.
The cleaner upperers.
All right. How many of you still remember Mr. Dixon?
Me.
Yeah. Who's Mr.
Dixon?
He
wasn't here then.
He wasn't even here. All right.
He was cool.
If you had a word for Mr. Dixon, what would you be saying to him now?
Hi, Mr. Dixon. We missed you.
Mr. Dixon.
Why weren't you here?
Pretty slack.
Where are you?
All right. What do you say about the night? Good night?
Oh, it was great.
It was hot.
It was great.
It was good fun, but
about that long.
How else would you describe it?
Can we do it again?
Okay, you want to do it again?
Yeah.
What, at the end of year 11?
Next week.
No, next week.
Next week, okay?
Next week.
We'll do the same thing, because we've got our, the final disco.
Yeah, the final disco.
Is that the final rage?
Yeah,
I guess so.
Final rage of our junior year.
England, if there was one thing you could do to improve the night, what would it be?
Oh, I can't answer that one. I cannot answer that one.
To improve what?
To improve the night, yeah.
I can't answer that one.
Why not, England? What would you want here? Drugs?
No, just a certain person.
A certain person.
All right, I want to Tristan in the mouth,
Tristan.
Please.
Tristan.
You don't get to say his name on camera.
Okay.
Embarrassing.
Okay.
What
well, if
my parents
watch
you?
Doesn't matter.
They're cool.
What do you got to say to Mr. Hamilton?
We love you, Mr. Hamilton.
No, I can't get that low. I can't get that low.
Oh, get my height. He's the best.
He's a really
good
guy.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. And what do you got to say to Mr. Perot, seeing as he allowed this to go on?
Thank you.
He didn't.
It's unofficial, but deep in his heart, he probably
Well, he wrote something on that screen up there, the computer screen, so we thank him. Cool.
Good on you.
He's the best.
He's the best deputy. Never leave Mr. Ashford. Never.
Never leave.
He is radical. Right. We couldn't handle Mr.
Until
okay, well, you guys are ready for senior years now?
Yeah.
No, of course, Nathan, quiet. I don't think you're
ready. Are you
not going
on? Aren't you going on?
Huh? Oh. Well, girls, give him a farewell, a hug, and whatever goes with saying. No. No? He's waiting for it.
Please don't make it.
Just England, imagine he's Tristan.
No,
maybe with the camera couldn't handle that.
Yeah, it might get all foggy.
All right, well, last wishes. What are we saying? Last chance of speaking.
Goodbye, junior years.
Goodbye, junior years.
We love you all. Now we're going to go and get drunk.
You are. Okay.
Farewell. Bye.
I've got the episode.
Bye.
Hello.
It's open! Brisbane, good night. Have a great time. Be careful. Bye-bye.
How did you feel Friday night, then, girls?
Good. It was really good.
Yeah? Sorry, you were pleased with it?
Yeah.
Now, you had a lot to do with the planning of it.
Yeah.
What was involved in planning?
Just organising everyone to come and tickets and food and
right.
decorations and things like that.
How many people actually came on the night? What percentage of the four? Was it as high as 90%?
Almost everyone.
Yeah. Righto. Jo,
yeah.
What did you think made the night special?
The awards.
Do you?
Yep.
Right. You think they were pretty clever?
Yeah.
Did you? I don't think you featured, did you? So I suppose you didn't feature in any of the awards, did you?
No.
But you thought that was good to. Well, why the awards?
I don't know. I just love it.
Okay. Did you enjoy dressing up for the night?
Yeah.
All right. Do you think every year 10 should have a ball?
Yeah.
All
right. I think it's really worth it, even though it's not
very
well.
Okay.
We've had it some.
And Kylie, we're going to ask them, if there's a teacher in this place that you'll remember in 10 years' time, who will that teacher be?
Mr. Conlon, I suppose.
Would that be right, Joan?
Yeah.
Mr. Conlon, why does he strike you as memorable?
His accent.
His accent. All right. Okay.
No.
No? Which teacher would you count as perhaps your favourite teacher?
I don't have one.
You don't have a favourite teacher, Joel? No? All right, which student do you think is going to be remembered among you in 10 years' time? Who would it be? Go on, just mention a name. Drop a name.
I remember.
Yeah, you'll remember each other, okay, as true friends. Okay, thanks for your time. Teacher, will you remember in 10 years' time? you don't have to have one answer.
Mr. Moriarty.
Every day of, mate.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Mr. Manwaring?
Moriarty.
Mr. Moriarty. Who would you say, Kate?
Mr. Manwaring.
Mr. Monwaring.
Manwaring.
Right.
Because he's not married, he's single.
Yeah.
We've got a
what?
Yes, that's what I
have. Oh, dear idea. All right, which student would you say you'll remember in 10 years' time?
Catriona
Willard.
Oh, God.
Catriona Willard, okay.
Bad memories, but yeah.
There we go.
No, and Bogman.
And who?
Bogman. Yeah.
And Daniel Armstrong.
Daniel Armstrong, that's it, yeah.
What do you call him? Bogman?
Bogman. Because when he was in primary school or something, he pooed his pants or something.
Oh, you're joking. We don't need that. What are you... Hey, look at these guys. Come on, Julie, say something to me. Who's going to be your favourite teacher?
I don't know. None of them haven't been here long enough.
Oh, come on. What about Mr. Archibald? He's pretty good, isn't he?
Oh, I suppose. Yeah, I'll probably remember him
and
Mr. Hamilton.
Righto.
Yeah.
Okay, who don't you... Could I just ask you who your teacher... Which teacher you'll remember in 10 years' time? For good or bad reasons, it doesn't matter. Mr. Arkapoor, sensational teacher, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Greatest.
Thank you, Michelle.
Hurry up.
Come on, Leanne, we haven't got all day.
I don't know.
You don't know. All right, well, which student would you think would be a sort of pick of year 10?
That's me.
Right, Michelle Forlong. Fair enough. Okay, thanks for your attention, please. Which teacher do you reckon you'll remember in 10 years' time?
Well, the teacher I remember is Mr. Erskine, because he's, like, the best teacher I know, because in our class there was Cameron Brown, Ben McGuinness, and...
Oh, the dudes.
And Stephen Sparks, and it was Mr. Erskine who taught us everything.
Taught you everything you know?
Taught us how to dress, like, I got PE today, but because you wear school...
Oh, you got PE today, yeah.
He taught us everything we knew, and he's just, he's a sexy bloke.
Yeah, all right. Which student do you reckon will be the most remembered student in 10 years? Damien, no problems. Thanks, Damien. Come back. Which teacher do you reckon you'll remember in 10 years' time?
Mr. Carl.
Mr. Carl will be your teacher, right. And what about best student of 1990, year 10?
No.
That's absolutely right. Right. Daniel, who would you remember in 10 years' time?
You.
Would you?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Mr. Arkwell. Okay. And what about the student that you think...
Me.
Absolutely right. Well, we've got the two winners there. See, Dan. We've got Romola here and Meredith. Okay, Meredith, you might go first. Which teacher will you remember in 10 years' time?
Oh, definitely.
Who is it?
You. Oh, most definitely.
You reckon?
No.
What? You just thought you'd say that.
Yeah, yeah, you were supposed to be in class.
All right, Romola, who would you remember?
Probably Erskine. Probably.
Mr. Erskine. Why is that?
Because he always picks on me.
Does he? What over? What is she?
She's his little shrub.
Oh,
shut up.
Shrub? Is that how he puts it?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, which student, Romola, Meredith, which student do you think has made the greatest contribution in year 10?
Russell Downs.
Russell Downs, yes. Infamy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who? Oh, Dennis.
Dennis Chow.
Dennis okay.
Ben.
You reckon? Between Dennis and Ben. Okay. Well, thanks for being part of the show, girls.
Any time.
Here we go. Tara, who would you remember in 10 years' time?
Miss McRae.
Mrs. McRae. All right. Why that? Why her?
Because I had to put up with her in my other school as well.
Did you? You came from one. Where was that? Sarah Redfern?
Macquarie Fields High.
Boy, you must have thought all of your bad luck had come together at one time, eh? Or do you appreciate it?
I appreciate it.
That's good. Okay, which student do you think? You've only been here, what, how long, a year?
Mm-hmm.
Which student stands out in your mind as the student of year 10, 1990?
God, no.
Don't have any? Just first name that comes to mind.
Hi, Mum.
Susan Smithers.
She's outstanding. Okay. And the question is, which teacher would you remember in 10 years' time?
Yeah, but how am I going to?
Probably Mr. Erskine.
Maybe. Mr. Erskine?
Yeah.
Yeah. Significant in your life? For what reason?
Oh, just pretty prominent, I don't know.
Yeah, it just stands out above everybody else. Sevenfold. Okay, which student do you think has made a big contribution in year 10?
I don't know, no one in particular.
Throw a few names around. Who stands out in your mind?
What's his name? Daniel Armstrong.
What's his name?
Yeah, right, Daniel Armstrong.
He's pretty outstanding.
Yes.
Dennis is pretty bright.
Yeah.
He's probably the brightest in the year.
Right.
I don't know, that's about it I can think of.
Okay, what about sporting wise? Who stands out?
Probably Leif.
Mm-hmm.
Kai.
Yeah.
He's probably got the most outstanding abilities.
Right. Now, in 10 years' time, if you had a reunion, what thing would you think back to over your 4 years of schooling as something that was memorable for you?
Probably our year at camp. That was pretty good.
Well, it was good.
Yeah,
wasn't?
That was
whereabouts did you
very
go for
memorable.
That?
Lane Cove in Sydney.
Okay.
That was really good.
And who took you to that? That was Mr. Hamilton?
Yeah, that was him. Yep.
And that was outstanding.
Yep, and probably the formal as well.
Right.
Pretty memorable.
Two good memories.
Yep.
Thanks for your time, Rachel.
Okay.
Okay, we go over to John. Your favourite teacher, or teacher that stands out in your mind?
Mrs. McClay.
Mrs. McClay.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's good. Why Mrs. McClay?
Because she failed me.
She failed? What, first teacher that ever failed John Wilmshurst, eh?
Yep.
So, all right, which student stands out in your mind that's important or a big name in the form?
None really stand out.
No? Is it a good bunch? Year 10, 1990?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's cool.
What sort of things do you think Year 10's done for the school? Any contributions that you've been outstanding in? Sport or academics?
Oh, yeah, a lot of sport. Yeah. Scott, Ray and Leaf and all that.
Right.
And music-wise, with Phil and Matt.
Right.
Someone else, can't remember.
Yeah. Well, there's a few big names.
Yeah.
All right. And what would be your memory over 4 years of high school? Best memory? First memory?
I don't know, I don't have one.
Well, all right. Do you find that Barrow High has been a good place to be in for 4 years? Or?
That's been good.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's pretty neat, yeah.
You're pleased you're here, not at Chev?
No, Fairbridge. No, I know, because the border's bashing.
That's on a trip down memory lane. There's a place just at the back of us which has been lost forever. That was important in your, about year 8 and year 7?
Yeah, year 7 and 8.
Year 7 and 8. Now, what area is that was so important to you here at school?
Well, there used to be two basketball courts and a big grass area.
And two demountables.
And two demountables. Yeah. And all of those are, if we pan around now, look at this. Gone, missing. Okay.
We used to play handball. And
right. Yeah. What are some of the memories, apart from handball? What chasing guys like who? Well, I can remember you guys playing handball constantly, even cricket.
Yeah.
British Bulldogs.
It was always handball, you just play handball.
Right, who was king more often than not in the game?
One of the guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I found that interesting that you guys played handball. Well, it's usually a sexist operation, isn't it? Guys play with guys.
We had. Everybody used to play. We used to have huge square things.
All right, so you're going to miss that? No, you don't miss it now. It's just part of the memory.
Yeah.
Part of the memory, all right. And what about the new block? Do you think it's been worth having as an asset to the school?
Yeah, I think the art room's pretty good.
Right.
It doesn't mean much to us, though, because by the time it's totally finished, we'll be gone. So.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, what about in 10 years' time, if there was to be a reunion, okay, what sort of memories would you brush over that would be the main, well, big memories for you? I've really put you on the spot here, haven't I? Is there one that stands out in your mind?
No.
No, it all seems to fade now that the camera's on.
Oh, yes.
Okay, well, thanks for bringing us back here. The basketball courts of year 7 and year 8. Okay, which years were they? That would have been...
87, 88.
87, 88. Okay, we've got Ben and Stephen here. What's the present role that you've got to all this?
Oh, well, this is the orientation day for year 6 kids coming into year 7 next year.
Okay. Now we're just showing around the school, know what's happening.
Sort of welcome to the jungle type.
Answering a bunch of questions and stuff.
Right. Now listen, these guys are being introduced to Year 10. Let me ask a few of them a couple of questions. What do you fellas think of these two Year 10 guys? If this is what Barrel High produces, are you looking forward to coming to Barrel High?
Yes.
Yeah?
No. Okay. This guy is
a bit of, he's a bit of a larrikin, is he? Who is this?
John Berry.
John Berry. What's up, John? Why? What a John the place already?
He wants to go home and have lunch.
Does he already?
John
okay, John. Do you realise that this school has got a proud record? Like, have a look at this Stephen Powell. This character has just got absolutely cupboards full of trophies for sporting achievements. And Ben Langford.
Renee Dix.
Yeah, Tony Fruin and Renee Dix. There are a few names that splash around. And Ben's got cupboards full of academic awards.
Plus all the sporting ones.
Yeah, and the sporting awards.
A whole lot of sporting ones.
Goody goodies. Goody
goodies. No, not goody goodies.
No. These are just par for the course.
You'll be just like us, if you're lucky.
4 years of training and you could be as groomed as these fellas here.
Yeah.
Well, we look forward to seeing you guys next year.
All right.
Yeah.
Carry on, Ben.
Okay.
Bye.
Thanks.
All right.
There's all your attention.
Is that camo under there? Benny the Loony. Well, listen, you guys prepared to talk on camera?
Oh, yeah.
They're not even prepared. There's Glenn, Sean here. Gentlemen, what do you think of the formal on Friday night?
It was good.
Yeah?
It sucked. I didn't like it at all.
You didn't like it?
No. Anything wrong with the food.
Yeah, the food was a bit...
The food was awful.
Yeah? Well, it's not worth the money we paid for. You expected better?
Yep.
What, more of it or better quality?
Better quality. Better quality and more.
Right. Well, it'd be hard to fill you then, I reckon.
Yep. Sure would be.
All right, well, in your years here at Barrel Eye, if I said to you, in 10 years' time, if there'd be a teacher you'd remember, who would it be?
There'd be two,
all right.
Mr. Ford and Mr. Carr.
Yeah? How come these two? What have they done?
Mr. There? Ford, because he's just a good teacher.
Right.
Always mucking around.
Yeah.
And Mr. Carr, because the same reason.
Right, they've got a good attitude.
Yeah, they're both good teachers.
Right. Sean, who would you remember?
Mr. Conlon.
Mr. Conlon, eh? Yeah, he's unforgettable. Yeah. And what about as far as form, year 10 students, who do you reckon... are the big runners in your form, the people that have made the form? I mean, in sport or school, I don't care.
Finno.
You reckon Finno's a...
Finn.
Yeah?
Finn football.
Well, a lot of people seem to think you were certainly for one of the awards. Hello, Ben.
Howdy.
Listen, Ben, do you reckon Glenn's got a point that Sean is one of the names of the year, year 10, 1990?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, I am too, of course.
Are you?
Yes.
One of the personalities.
Yes. Mean Finn.
You and Finn, right?
One of the personalities of Year 10 for sure.
Now, what about teachers? Just ask the guys on the score of 10 years passes. Who would you remember among the teachers?
The most.
Oh, well, comes to mind.
That's a hard decision.
Conlon, yeah.
Probably Conlon?
He just sticks in the back of your mind.
Yeah, does he, Darren?
Sweet.
Okay.
Mr. Vandermeer too, but he's
Mr.
gone.
Mr. Vandermeer, yeah, well, there's a name. Yeah, people will remember that one.
He He was pretty impossible to get along with, no matter how hard you tried.
Yeah.
Put me in the green room, actually. Had a teacher that's ever done it to me. Not good at all.
Yeah. So, Mr. Vandermeer, you'd have a message for him, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
What would that be? well, express, Ben. I taught you English in year 8, didn't I? I don't think I ever got to that level. Darren, which other people do you reckon make year 10 a good year?
Our group.
Your group. Who makes up your group? That's everybody over there.
Yeah, film them over there.
Everyone under the tree. Well, just rattle a few names past us. Who are the guys?
Linda Edwards.
Right.
Fletcher.
Nate Cupid.
Yeah.
Darren King. Daniel Stafford. Glenn
Travis
Cooper.
Newman.
Travis Newman.
All right.
Steve and Clyde. Hey,
what I want to notice about Travis, what's he wearing today? Is he still
Bugs.
In his corduroys?
Yeah, Bug eyes. Corduroy shorts, yeah, of course.
Good.
Oi, Trav! Bug! Come here! Come here!
He's got the pose of a model, hasn't he? Look at the hand on his hip there. You think he knew it?
And we got Clines in the school.
Hello, we've got a few others that have come in here. Tim.
No, man.
Tim, who would you reckon to be some of the memorable teachers you've had in the years
I'd
here?
I'd say Conlon.
Yeah.
You.
Yeah. Dead set.
Yeah. Moriarty.
You've put me in that category, have you? Moriarty, Conlon and Arkapor. Crikey. Thanks very much.
That's all right.
Hey, who are the people that make up the form, like student-wise?
Ben,
yeah.
Gouldy, Rhonda.
That's me.
Yeah.
Everyone, man.
Who's Grunter? Is that the nickname for Glenn, is it?
No, yeah. Rhonda.
Rhonda. Yeah. Who's Rhonda?
Yeah. Little Trav here, little Trav.
Bug hasn't got his corduroys on.
Travis, he makes up the year as well.
On, sir.
Have you, mate?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm really pleased to see it. Gee.
What do you reckon?
Yeah, well, fashionable. Listen, Travis, is it true what they say about your smoking habits?
No.
That they're prolific? Oh, crikey, we're downwind and I can smell you. Like having a six-pack.
They're full of shit.
Are they? Yeah. It's just not on, is it?
No.
No, your standard growth relates to other things.
Yeah.
You've got a short pygmy for a father.
Look at his eyes, sir.
No.
He can't smoke,
Travis,
sir.
Who would you count as the most memorable teacher you've ever had in this school? Oh, well, then, yeah, got a few in mind. Throw a few names in. Can't think of anyone?
Who sticks in your head?
Prattis.
I can say one, two teachers I hate.
Jansen.
He's a big dickhead.
That's it.
I'll put seconds on
He's
that.
A werewolf.
Yeah.
I'll put thirds for sure. I've had a roll call for 4 years.
All right. There's fourths on it. Okay. Well, that seems fairly much.
Hey, Mr. Arkwell, do us a favour and don't show him. Not until we're gone, anyway.
No, well, it's protected. We're going to try and preserve this for your own reunions. It'll come up in time. Okay, yeah, gentlemen, thank you for speaking to me.
It's all right.
You can run, but you can't hide, girls.
What? What you mean?
Grandstand. What an act. What do you remember of your most famous teacher at Barrow High? Who would you remember?
No, mate.
No? Okay, well, Jeremy, that's all we'll ever remember of you. No, mate. Russell, you've had 4 years in the place. Okay.
Yeah.
Who would you remember in those 4 years as your most memorable teacher?
I'd say...
Mr. Chocorelli. Glad to hear his name mentioned, right? And that's... Why? Why do you feel that?
School teacher.
School teacher, right. Okay, well, who are the people that make your form a memorable form? Like, which names come to mind as far as outstanding scholars or sportsmen or something?
Finn.
Yeah?
Mouse.
Sean Finneran gets another vote. Gee, Sean.
Me.
Yeah?
Me.
Why you, mate?
Because I'm just number one.
Just so spectacular.
Then Mouse.
Okay.
You know.
If in 10 years you had to come back to the school for a reunion...
Yeah.
What would you reckon you'd have as a word about the school and your life 4 years in the place?
I'd just say, keep out of trouble.
Yeah?
It's
not worth getting into trouble.
Yeah, that's right.
Have you managed to keep out of trouble most of years?
Oh, not really. No.
Okay, mate. Well, thanks for your opinions.
All right.
And we'll see you anon.
All right.
Most memorable teacher is?
Mr. Carr.
Yeah?
Is
that right? Why is that?
Oh, he's got a way he teaches, like he
Not like most teachers.
Not like most teachers. Boring.
Yeah, he makes it more exciting, and he really gets in there and does something.
Oh, good. Okay. Darren, we've already had your selection.
It's got to be Mr. Prattis.
Mr. Prattis is good, is he? Yeah. He's good value. There he goes. Well, listen, you're getting a good vote here, Mr. Prattis. One of the most memorable teachers. If they went away, they'd remember woodwork. Is it woodwork, Alice?
You didn't ask me about my good memorable teacher.
Oh, well, your good memorable teacher.
I said my other teacher before is not the best. Oh, I'd have to say Mr. Prattis and Mr. Carr.
Yeah? No. Dead set.
Yeah, dead set.
No. But listen, Ben, the assessments have been done. You can't win any marks here, can you, Mr. Prattis? Oh, sorry.
Right. No, the best...
favourite student.
Yeah, he's a top one.
The best teacher is Miss Clayton.
Miss Clayton?
If you want to be suspended in a green room on level 2, just say, Miss, go play with your organ.
That's it. That's the end of it. And you've done that, Phil?
So that I've done that. Different things. Yeah. I failed music.
Because of a comment like that?
Because I'll see if Adam agrees.
Adam? Yeah. Miss Clayton is it. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
okay. Mr. Carl?
Yeah.
Okay. Who are the people that make your form? Who are the names that student-wise?
Oh, Jeremy Hartnell.
Oh, Jeremy Hartnell, yeah, he's memorable. Who is Jeremy?
Tony's sideburns, already what a character.
Oh, yeah, Tony's... Are they sideburns, Tony?
Yeah, they're growing good.
Hey, what, you got a contest with
Damien,
have you? Well, it's a mismatch, isn't it? Because neither
of you... Hey, have you seen that kid in Year 7 or Year 6 who looks just like...
Rhonda.
Yeah, Rhonda's taking him around.
That's his brother, isn't it?
No, he got real cut when someone said that.
We thought it was his brother.
I asked him if it was brother.
You want to take up a bit of close shot, bit of Year 10 growth on the chin?
On the chin?
Yeah.
Why, is that...
Please take a close note.
No, sorry, I can't... I won't focus on that one, Ben. Right. That one that you've got there, mate.
All right.
Okay, gentlemen, well, thanks for your honest opinions.
Thank you, sir.
And Brendan, you got a last word to say? No. Okay, well, I didn't expect you would, but still, we'll give you a chance.
They're a disturbed class.
They're a disturbed class.
I enjoyed the night, if nobody else did. Brought back a few memories for me. I haven't had a dance like that for a while. Made me feel a bit young again, I suppose. Mm-hmm. It was an experience. And I'll recommend to Mr. Anderson next year that he doesn't do it. It was a bit of hard work, and Mr. Anderson, I don't think he'll be up to it, and I don't think his Year 9 will be up to it by next year. I was pretty pleased with the way the kids behaved.
They were about 90% there, weren't they? Or is it?
Yeah, we had 162 students out of 186. Right. So that was a pretty good roll-up. Mm-hmm. Hi to all the antisocial ones who couldn't be there on the night.
Right. They missed something. It was a good night.
Oh, I think they missed something, yeah. I think most people had a pretty good time. Right.
If you're going to change it, what would you change? Would you put it in a different venue, or do you think...
Well, I think the venue was fine. It would have been nice to have it at the school, but it wasn't possible.
Right.
Probably leave Josh Hoogland and Damien Hilton at home. That might improve things.
Right. Well, they're the characters of the form, and I mean, what would it be without them, eh?
Yes, everyone can identify with them.
Yeah.
But I don't think I'd change too many things. Yeah. If I get all the kids to sit down during dinner time, that'd be a start, I suppose. But. I know they were pretty hyped up and pretty excited, and I suppose it's to be expected. Oh, I must say they scrubbed up pretty well on the night.
Oh, they did too.
Yeah. A bit hard to recognise a few of them.
Is it Tara Lee that had the hair changed drastically into a brilliant red?
Geez, I've forgotten now.
Yeah, someone there.
A few spring to mind. Natalie Flink.
Right.
Had her hair all done up.
Right.
I was pretty impressed with all of them, so it was good.
Well, just in general, how do you find them as a form? I mean, you've had them now, what, 3.5 years?
3.5 years, yeah. Oh, well, there's not too many occasions I've thanked Mr. Dixon, but probably next Friday, when they've all left, I'll thank him. I've been pretty happy with them all along.
Right. Yeah. Who are the characters that would stand out in your mind for either good or bad reasons? Are there some people that have made the form in whatever way, sporting, academic?
Yes, there's a few that spring to mind. Phil Backwood, mm-hmm. he stands out in my mind as a character. Daniel Armstrong, okay, one that springs to mind, that his name's brought up just about every week, although I must admit recently, been pretty good.
Yeah.
Sporting, Leif Mackay, I think has done outstandingly well over the last 4 years.
Yeah.
Dennis Chow probably gets not enough recognition.
Right.
He does very well across the curriculum. And John Evans, of course. There's some outstanding ones here. Susan Greenbank, done very well. Excuse me.
If these guys were to meet in 10 years' time, do you think they'd sort of turn up in the numbers that we had them at the formal? Are they cohesive?
Well, I think they're a pretty close-knit bunch. Yeah. I think ever since, the Year 7 camp,
yeah,
out at Fitzroy Falls, and the Year 8 camp up in Sydney, that brought a lot of them together. I think if they had a reunion, I think a lot of them would be in it.
Right.
Yeah, I'd be keen to get something off the ground anyway in a few years' time.
Right. Okay, mate, well, thanks for your time. And any last words of encouragement to them as a form as they look at the future?
Well, all the best. Good wishes to the leavers, and all the best, and I suppose good wishes to the students that are going on as well.
Yeah.
Right. They deserve what they get, I suppose.
This is his impersonation of Elephant Man. No? Got anything to say about the farewell, Hamish? Enjoy them?
Yeah.
Yeah?
It was all right.
Tell me what, you just did an Ian Crick lookalike there.
A who?
A Crick lookalike. It was all right. Enjoyed it?
Mm.
Hmm. Is that as animated as Hamish gets?
No, probably.
Is that as animated as he gets?
Yep.
Yeah, that's
all
it.
All the time, it's like that all the time.
Okay. Tell me what, next time, are you going to stay on, Hamish?
Yeah.
Please do Ian Crick satire when you go into year 12.
Right.
Tell you what, you are a spitting image.
Will we be having a year 12 one of these?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
if
good.
I'm here,
that's
still alive.
Collection.
Yeah. Okay, gentlemen.
Gentlemen?
Yeah. I've always thought of equality in sexes.
True.
And Andrew, if you had one teacher that you could remember, or a couple of teachers, which teachers would they be?
Mr. McRae, probably.
Yeah? You got a reason for that?
No, he just suspended me twice, put me in the isolation room twice, and he just loves hassling me out.
So he's made an impression upon you?
Yeah, yes.
Okay. Exactly. What about good, in terms of good memories, who would you have?
Don't really have any.
Don't you?
No.
No memories, no good memories whatsoever. Right. Which kids make the form for you? Which students make year 10 for you? Like names that spring to mind? Mates?
Just everyone, I suppose.
Yeah. As a form, do you think they've left an impact on the school?
Yeah, certainly.
Yeah? And most of those impacts are up in the boys' toilets and the girls' toilets, aren't they?
Yeah.
Right. Well, thanks for that, Andrew.
No worries.
The figure that you're looking at is Mrs. Carlin. Which room are we in, fellas?
D1.
We're presently, let me just pan around the room.
Get real, mate.
Get real.
This
is a typical setting for an English class. Is it an English class or a history class?
English.
There's Felicity Anthers. I recognise that. Swat that fly, did you? Well, as I've said to you, Mrs. Carlin, you've been randomly selected as the most fair-minded teacher to give an impression of Year 10.
And the only one available.
And the only one available, this way, yes.
What do you think? My impression of Year 10. Well,
watch what you say.
We're really cool, aren't we?
We know this guy.
Excuse me, I've just asked Mrs. Carlin. don't write a script.
They speak for themselves. We've done a lot of oral work this
have you?
Year, Mr.
what do they call that? A euphemism? A lot of oral work, yes. There's Louise. Yeah, I recognise Louise sitting right out the front there. That would be her position, would it? Typically? Louise, is that you? It is, behind that hand. I recognise it. Yeah. Well, impressions?
Well, I wouldn't call my class an average Year 10 class.
Yeah.
It's definitely not average.
Is that overdoing it, overstating it, average?
Average? Oh, no, they're all wonderful individuals in this class.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very, very much individuals.
Right.
Some very strong personalities in the class, like Reg.
Reg? Who's Reg? I don't know the name. Oh, Reg Hertz, of course. Listen, Reg, we didn't have that lunchtime interview. Let's just do it quickly now. Okay, Reg, you wanted to get onto the camera. You're on. Who would you remember in 10 years' time, Reg, as your most famous and favourite teacher? Who would it be? Oh, looks spectacular. Graham Kennedy action there. Is he normally this? Come on, Reg, give me an answer quick. 5 seconds.
Yeah, Mr. McRae.
It's got to be your favourite, has he?
No, yes.
Who gives you the worst nightmares? I mean, do you have nightmares about teachers?
Yeah, Mr. Pratis gives me.
Does he?
Yeah.
And is there a connection between being sent from Mr. Prattis to Mr. McRae? Quite often? No. Okay, you missed that question. I'll come back to Mrs. Carl, I think. Get some reason.
Of course, Reg this year is one of our best story writers.
Story writer?
Yes. Reg wrote the ultimate story on football, of course.
Right, football.
It was a sensational story.
So he'll be writing probably for The Sun, or
I'd say so, yes.
Not The Sun, I mean, some other extinct paper.
Mirror.
Telegraph Mirror, yes.
So, yes, we're expecting big things of Reg and his writing.
Yeah.
I don't know how many of them are talented in English, but some of them are talented in other things.
Yeah.
I mean, Tim's a very talented woodworker.
Actually, Tim, you'll be interested to know, where's Tim? Tim, I've just taken a shot of your work out the front there. So those that have a look at the work, this is the creator here. Okay? Tim, would they call you Gonzo by any stretch of the imagination? I'm just looking at you in relief and thinking...
No, they call me something else.
Do they? Ah, well, we won't get into that. Okay, yes.
I must say, I often look at Tim as relief in this class because you need some relief in this class.
Do you? Right.
Yes, and Tim often provides that.
Right.
Yes. But overall, I'd say it was a nice, well, my class in particular are very nice.
Yeah.
They're very easygoing. They're not what you call an uptight group of people.
Not what you'd say motivated.
Oh, motivated, yes.
But within reason. Oh, that's the bell. Reactions.
Oh,
okay, this is typical Year 10. Well, Mrs. Carl, I just thank you for that honesty and catching things.
Great pleasure.
Miss Evans here, is she?
I did have
Oh, look at that. Has Mr. Ashford seen you in this uniform?
Yes, he has, and he couldn't believe it.
Yeah,
he couldn't believe his eyes.
I can't believe it either.
Oh, look, it's terrific.
Just stop there, mate. I mean, keep him on. Okay. Reg, you've got to give me some background on the score of why Mr. Pattis is one of those bad memory teachers.
Well, he lost one of the dowel jig things, which we drill the holes into, and we asked Mr. Pratis to drill the holes.
Yeah.
He ended up drilling the holes in Squiff.
Really?
That way and that way.
And he calls himself an IA teacher.
Yeah, that's right.
He's really an IM teacher, is that it?
Yes, that's what we all think.
Yeah.
And we put it all together and all the job ended up to be Squiff out of the place here and out of place there. And splits in our wood here and splits out of wood here. And
all his fault?
All was his fault.
And he gives it a mark? And what mark does he give it?
Well, at the moment he's giving it 80.
80? Okay, Reg, well, thanks for that, mate. We needed to have that background information.
Oh, that's good.
Who's calling that out, mate?
That's that bloke over. See that one walking over
there? Yeah, who is it?
That's Michael.
Yeah.
That's Michael.
Thanks, Michael Smith.
He always does that.
Now, Susan, I will give you £10 and you will tell me who employed you to listen to our conversation.
okay?
Yep.
Well, at least, well, you're going to be our last person on tape.
Mm-hmm.
You were organising the formal with Susan. Where did the idea come from for the formal?
Well, they've had formals before, and we just thought, with everyone leaving, that we'd like to have some dinner or something to everyone.
Now, you got a bit discouraged when the school wasn't going to back it.
Yeah, well, they didn't want it because from the history of all the other Year 10 formals, there's something bad happened, so the school didn't want it, and they didn't want us to have it at the hall, so we had to find somewhere else to have it.
Right. Now, who's pressuring is that? I mean, who were the people who motivated and said, we're not going to accept no for an answer? Was that you and Susan?
Yeah, we, like, Mr. Pro didn't want it. Mr. Hamilton wasn't fussed on the idea at first, but he got more involved.
Right.
But we just wanted to have something, so we just kept going for it.
Right. And now that it's over, was it worthwhile?
Yeah, it was good. I hope everyone enjoyed themselves. It was Everyone got to see each other for the last time before they all went to work and stuff, beneficial that way.
Okay. If you're going to say to people who are organising future farewells or formals, what are some bits of advice you've given?
Just to organise the money and stuff, because that was hard. No one cooperated, they all paid at the last minute.
Yeah.
But it's not much else, just try and get organised quickly.
Yeah.
But it was good though.
Okay. If in 10 years you were asked to think of a teacher that you felt was a good teacher in the years you've been at Barrow, which names would come to mind?
Oh, I don't know.
Or just the first ones that came to mind?
I don't know, Mr. Carl, because he's pretty funny. Mr. Hamilton, because he's a good year advisor. He's taken us on excursion, or he's done something for us each year.
Yeah.
All the teachers are pretty cool.
Okay. All right, which people do you think have made the year a good year, Year 10, students?
Oh, everyone's just put in, and our whole year's just one big thing now, and no one in particular's made it anything. So. Right. Everyone's just
a good cohesive bunch.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, and if in 10 years you were going to have a reunion, what would you reckon would be the roll up like?
Well, I certainly hope everyone would come. It would be really interesting to see what everyone would look like.
Right.
Good.
What do you reckon would happen to you in 10 years?
Oh, I
married
don't know.
With children?
I hope not. I don't want to be married with children. We're flying around the world.
Right. Okay. Well, thanks for the time you've spent.
It's okay.
And thanks for organising the form.
It's all right.
It's been good. All right.
Okay, thanks.
School Day Blues!
Yes. moving over time certainly does help.
That's too far, that ball was more than 50 metres.
We're talking with the captain of Jib and vice-captain, Lee Mackay. How good is this year?
Oh, big year for Jib, mate.
Is it?
He's not last year's good, mate. Look, the swimming carnival, athletics and cross-country.
Oh, all the
big three.
Yeah, the big three. Yeah, trifecta.
We didn't even have to get into the pool again today. Right. The winch, you know?
Well, have you got a theme for 1991? What's your theme?
What a joke.
What are you working on? Is that the idea?
Yep.
Well, what do you think of Belmore's idea of coming over with Scud missiles?
Nah, full of shit.
Belmore. We're with Belmore. How do we have sign over there?
What's it say?
Oh, we've got a banana punching out a shark.
Ah, right.
Yeah, big year.
So, what do you think of Jib's chances this year?
Oh, we're
not
out of that.
No doubt about it.
This is the only thing that's going to...
You guys are absolutely cocky.
It's by how many hundred we win. That's it.
Yeah,
is that
unstoppable.
It's not a case of...
Unstoppable.
Not a case of who, but by how much?
Yep.
Yeah,
definitely.
Okay, well, thanks for your words, Ben.
Catch ya.
What about this for a long time, and this year we decided that green would be the theme that Hume would run with this year.
Okay.
If you have a look around here, you'll notice green hats, green shirts.
Green grass.
Green everywhere, green grass. We've even talked the trees into becoming Hume members this year.
Oh, good.
Which was really a big step. And next year, the council's agreed to tile the pool
in green tiles. Fantastic. Okay, have you got a motto for the year at all, like second is best?
Our motto this year is first or nothing. So it's going to be mass suicide at the end of the day if we don't win the carnival.
Right. So we'll look to see all the Hume down at the bottom of the deep end.
They're all going to be alive and the others will be in the bottom of the pool because we're going to win this one.
Well, thanks for your confidence, Mr. Charlie.
You're welcome, Mr. Ryan.
Well, Tracy Cowgill, and Tracy, what's Belmore's theme this year?
Bombers, we're going to blow everyone out of the water.
Blow everybody out of the water, right. And we brought along our cruise missile.
Yep.
Scud missiles.
Yep.
Patriot missiles that works, have we?
How come we got all
the... Yeah. Our chances are good.
Yeah, we're coming second at the moment, so...
Right.
I really think we might do well.
Well, can we bridge that big gap that Jib's got on us?
I hope so.
Okay. Yeah. Well, thanks for that.
That's all right. Don't you ever do that again. Gibraltar actually had far superior numbers in each event, and the events were 3 points for entry points yesterday.
So
Gibraltar got a very big lead, and also they had a lot of good juniors. But we had Belmore were close second, followed by Fitzroy and Hume.
Fitzroy up there.
Fitzroy were there.
Yeah. All right. What were the point scores at the end of the day?
Ooh, now you're testing me. Hume had 200, Fitzroy had 203, and Belmore had 343, and Gibraltar had 545, so it was a big lead.
200 points, I mean, that's pretty hard to win the race.
And I think Gibraltar have got the enthusiasm today, as you can see from all the
They've got a good flow on, huh? They've got a lot of confidence swimmers, haven't they?
We've got a couple of new swimmers, Julie Multani, who has broken two records yesterday, and she's broken one record today.
Yeah.
So she's done very well. She swam in the country championships only a week ago. But Hume House has got a good young swimmer, Daniel Woods, who has broken three records as well.
Right.
So Leslie Woods' younger brother, who's going to rewrite the record books.
Well, actually, we've got a couple coming up through a guy called Abbott, coming up from Barrel Primary. We're priming him. And a few others. Starts with
Belmore need all their help they can get.
Because they're going to
miss Paul Brown this year.
Yeah.
And he's broken two records as well, yesterday and today. So they'll be losing him and a lot of points.
Right.
And young Tim Merriman also got a record. And Meredith Pope from Gibraltar again got a record yesterday.
Yeah, it's so sickening. It's sickening.
It's just too much. And Gibraltar's going to win.
Oh, get out of here. Here we go, Brownie. Yeah, Brownie. Yeah, look, I've got to talk to this gold medalist who sets records, no less.
What an animal, what a body.
Thanks, Duncan. Listen, Brownie, Belmore's chances is 1991. What have we got?
Excellent. We've got it
with Fitzroy.
We've got it one. I mean, Fitzroy. This is the best Fitzroy can do. We've got it one easy.
Maybe we can combine our points.
This is the best Fitzroy can do. Jason Alden, Duncan James.
He even likes Fitzroy.
No. Belmore, Blue Tower.
He's disgraced in Belmore.
Nah.
Well, listen, what are our chances of Scud? We're going to Scud missile this Gibraltar side. I mean, they are the big guns.
We'll do them like a dinner.
Yeah.
Still early, yeah.
It's too early to judge.
Early days.
Yeah, they're too cocky. I think they're just too confident. Maybe they can trip just at the end of the race and go past. Okay, well, we've got the twilight tonight. Have we got big chances?
Huge
chances.
We've
got Fitzroy, but that's for sure.
Righto. We've got Fitzroy. We've got them coming.
Hurry.
This is the best Fitzroy I can do.
Nothing yet.
Yeah. Hey, listen, but you guys got third last year, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. We won an athletics carnival about 3 years back.
Hey, that's a good memory.
Here goes Mark Eaton, another Fitzroy. Another Fitzroy man.
Major Fitzroy asset.
No idea.
What?
Okay,
Phil. Hey, you think it's an athletics carnival, Mark? Is this what they reckon?
What's that?
They're all saying you're ready for an athletics carnival.
What do you think of the strides down here, too?
Mark.
Hang on, he thinks it's a cross country then, doesn't he?
This happens to be a major
He thinks he's going to the beach. I can't wait for the watermelon scramble.
Fitzroy to win. Fitzroy might have a chance. Fitzroy.
This is sensational. Is she beating herself? Wait a minute, I think the shadow's going to do her.
You win. Go and give Mr. Walker
your... Kathy, can I just have an interview? Kathy, are you the only Year 11 girl doing this novelty event? Is that the story? Quickly, just look at me. You're drowning. I hope you do.
Oh, excellent value. Hello. Excellent value. We've had just finished our waiting races and we're just about to go into...
But is this any indicator? We just had one person from Year 11.
Well...
Kathy Orman.
That's year 11.
So that shows.
That's year 11. That's year 11. Yeah. The others have been very, very well represented in all the houses. Excellent stuff.
Okay. It's hard keeping up with you, mate.
Sorry. I'm hyped. I'm hyped. Ready to go.
Right. Oh, well, I won't stand in your way much longer. Okay. How Belmore doing?
Belmore are fantastic. Belmore are excellent. Belmore are going to win. Belmore is Belmore.
Good. So, you look like you've got some sort of illness.
Yeah, I'm